Well, we wanted it. Well, it's interesting because when Vince came to me when I started working with him, and like when I was 18 years old, his pitch to me was like he wants to get Asian voices heard in the entertainment business, whether it's in theater or film. So I've been lucky enough to, benefit off of that and whatnot. So the group we have here is a accumulation. We have four people from the VmediArts team. So we were like, we're gonna grab them right away. And then we have two amazing singers, Mara and Casey, who are not part of the team but are just, friends of the community, and we just wanted to share the love and whatnot. But my first song is by Adam Guam, who wrote Scotland PA, but my song is from his original one of his original shows, Ordinary Days, and it's a song called Favorite Places. And if you can see, I have flags in my room. So when I was in college, I would think about, my home in Oakland, which is where I'm currently at, and then I'd also think of my ancestral home of Okinawa. So it's just some of these verses kind of reflect on like how I think of Oakland and how I think of Okinawa. And like I live in New York now, so it's just like the show takes place in New York. So it made me feel a little bit more back at one of my second or third homes, essentially, during this pandemic,
That's a beautiful theme and a great way to kick off the night. So, Daniel's going to make he and I disappear and break a leg. And thanks again for everything, Oscar.
On my block, there's a garden tucked away behind this carriage house. I could see it from my window, stretching towards the sidewalk. And though I've looked there for many years, I never found the entrance to this perfect little place I'd like to go. But still, it's one of my favorite places. One of my most favorite places. A patch of green I've only seen from much too far away. When I was 5 or 6, my mother, she would tell these awesome stories of a magic land that floated high above the treetops. And every night I'd fall asleep and dream that I could fly there, that I could find this floating kingdom in the sky. But still, I try, 'cause it is one of my favorite places, one of my most favorite places. But here's the twist, it can't exist. So why do I keep thinking that it does? It's all so clear, and yet it seems so distant, like I'm reaching for mirages in my mind. And all I want is someone who can show me all these places that I've dreamed about but never seem to find, because all of my favorite places, all of my most favorite places are places that I've never been. In my bed, there's a woman sleeping well into the morning. I like watching how the sunlight trickles down her shoulder. And though I've tried so many times to tell her that I love her, haven't found a way inside her heart. And it would be one of my favorite places, one of my most favorite places, one more favorite place that I've never been.
someone you like is nearby. And a ticklish, tingling, trembling begins when they look you in the eye. And the butterflies in your stomach start to lift you off the ground. Deep inside, you can't stop screaming. Still, there's not the slightest sound. And the smile in your heart is a thousand times bigger than a smile could ever be. That's kilig. As we say in Filipino, brushes your hand, how you start to stutter and sputter and shudder and say stupid things you hadn't planned. It's the room insanely spinning, it's the shivers down your spine, it's the jungles of sensations you can't even hope to define. And your brain is exploding, it's driving you crazy, you wish that it would.
Yes, I know a girl, and I'm in love with her. Can't help but smile each time I think of her. But it seems she's gone to hiding, and it's you I find. So unlike the image of the girl I have in mind. She is beautiful and adventurous, with a sunlight in her glow. She was dear to me, she was almost mine, but I guess I moved too slow. And though you might still resemble her, I'm not so sure that you're still the girl I know. She isn't soft or coy, she doesn't flirt. Her rough and tumble ways and stubborn words are what seized this fisherman's attention, cause it's hard to dream. No pretentious airs about her, just a subtle gleam. Such a simple face, such a humble heart, not some piece of art for show. She is radiant, she is something else, but you're not that girl I know. She be cleaning the nets of the fish from the catch has been ferried, and I secretly vowed if her heart would allow we'd be married. But one day she was gone, she never took into my love for her. And she was beautiful, she was something else. I was a fool to let her go. But I've tried in vain to convince myself that you're still that girl I know. You are beautiful. You are something else, but you're not the girl I know.
Notice his head drooping, notice his horse stooping, notice the spear pointing toward a canyon unseen. A people pushed to the edge, captured in this one scene. Fall or jump off the ledge, there's no in between. That is the wonder of art. Whether you're servant or whether you're king, when a great artist imparts what he's feeling and shows you something remarkable, how beauty can surface from such despair, compelling one person to sit and stare and see something remarkable, incomparable. The murals and statues around the fair, each one a creation remarkable to share with all of the world. Wonder if I'm that good wonder if my hands could craft something so marvelous and rare to behold. They say my paintings are nothing new and nothing bold. No captivating point of view, or so I'm told. Should I just play Japanese beyond painted screens? Is there more I can bring? My odd sense of humor and these silly drawings amount to nothing remarkable. If I laid what's inside me and laid it bare, would they simply deride me or even care? Would they call me remarkable? Impossible to know if my wager is worth the dare, to know if I've something remarkable to share with all of the world. I've got to find something remarkable, remarkable to share with the world.
There once was a little girl playing on a swing set. When her grandpa built by the sycamore tree near the rusty farmyard gate, while her mama pinned the laundry, the little girl would cry out loud, "Push me higher, push me higher, push me, I can't wait." Her mama would push a couple times, but there was laundry still to do, so she learned to use her own strength, push on through to swing higher, higher than before, higher, but scared to reach for something more, higher, higher towards the sky, until the day she bent to kiss her mama a last goodbye. Little boy who loved that swing set. He had a licorice twist from the store in town and two knobby skinned up knees. While his sister pinned the laundry, that little boy would cry out loud, "Push me higher, push me higher, push me, pretty please." The girl would push a couple times, but there was laundry still to do. Then she watched amazed as suddenly he pulled his own way through to swing higher, higher than she dared, higher. He flew so high and wasn't scared, higher. He could touch the sky. Right then she knew that he would also one day tell her goodbye. That little boy, he seemed so sure. Was it something never taught to her? How the years passed quickly by. The girl's a woman still afraid to try. Is it too late to start again? Get back that feeling I had then. But now my life is upside down. There's no more farm, there's no more town, and no use asking why. But I won't let it pass me by. Life won't pass me by. I'll fly. Get back on that swing higher.
But, you know, Sarah Bareilles did this amazing show called Waitress. And, you know, it's a very diverse cast. But the point that I want to bring with this song is that Asians can be goofy without using an accent. And so I'm going to show y'all that I love you like it's able.
I love that.
Your white dress sparks words spontaneous. And I'll sing from mountaintops. I am in love and I don't care who knows it. Lucky me, I was ordinary. But with your love, you'll see I am a poem writer. I will express this if I'm able. I love you like a table. My legs were carved for you. I love you like a table. I am wood and you are glue. Cover me with stuff and I will hold you up, strong and stable. I love you like a table.
Proud of your boy, I'll make you proud of your boy. Believe me, bad as I've been, Ma, you're in for a pleasant surprise. I've wasted time, I've wasted me. So say I'm slow for my age, a late bloomer. Okay, I agree that I've been one rotten kid. Some sun, some pride, and some joy. But I'll get over these lousing up, messing up, screwing up times. You'll see, Ma, now comes the better part. Someone's gonna make good, cross his stupid heart. Make good and finally make you proud of your boy. Tell me that I've been a louse and a loafer. You won't get a fight here, no ma'am. I say I'm a gold brick, a goof off, no good. But that couldn't be all that I am. Water flows under the bridge, let it pass, let it go. There's no good reason that you should believe me, not yet. I know, but someday and soon I'll make you proud of your boy. So don't look back, cause that boy that you knew isn't there anymore. And Mom, those dreams that you had for me, I'll make sure they happen, I guarantee. Mom, I will try hard to make you proud of your boy.
So they say, all I know is I don't know what to write or the right way to write it. This is Big Lady, don't screw it up. This is not some little vaudeville I'm reviewing. Poor little kids versus rich, greedy, sour pusses, huh? It's a cinch. It can practically write itself, and let's pray it does. Because I may have mentioned I have no clue what I'm doing. Am I insane? This is what I've been waiting for. Well, that plus the screaming of 10 angry editors. A girl, it's a girl. How the hell is that even legal? Look, just go and get her. Not only that, there's a story behind the story. Thousands of children exploited, invisible. Speak up, take a stand, and there's someone to write about it. That's how things get better. Give those little guys some ink, and when it dries, just watch what happens. The kids will live and breathe right on the page, and once they're center stage, you watch what stoically charismatic, plain spoken, no nothing, skirt chasing, cocky little son of a. Lie down with dogs and you wake up with a raise and a promotion. So he's a flirt, a complete egomaniac. The fact is he's also the face of a strike, not a face. Face the fact, that's a face that could save us all from sinking in the ocean. Like someone said, power tends to corrupt an absolute. Power weight corrupts absolutely. That is genius! But give me some time, I'll be twice as good as that. 6 months from never. Just look around at the world we're inheriting and think of the one we'll create. Their mistake as they got old, that is not a mistake we'll be making. No, sir, we'll stay young forever. Give those kids and me the brand new century and watch what happens. It's David and Goliath, do or die. The fight is on and I can't watch what happens. But all I know is nothing happens if you just breathe in. It can't be any worse than how it's been. And it just so happens that we just might win. So whatever happens, let's begin.
There's a town that I call home, where all the streets are paved with soul. Down in Butte there's a honky-tonk bar, hear the wail of a blues guitar. Have a beer, drop a dime in a blind man's jar. Blues sing softly in the air, like a Sunday morning prayer. Just one more drink and you'll see God everywhere. Like a sad old melody, tears you up but sets you free. That's how Memphis lives me. There comes a time when muddy waters run rough. There comes a point when a man has had enough. Like a friend who always stands by me. Yeah. Memphis knows me, Memphis shows me how this life just has to be. I couldn't even try to run away and say goodbye. Here I was born and here's where I'll die. Just so me, yeah. Memphis knows me, Memphis shows me how this life just has to be. I couldn't even try to run away. Here I was born, and here's where I'll die. Whoa, just a man from Tennessee can't be what I can't be. All I know is Memphis good. All I know is Memphis good.
Virginia, ran away from home at 10. got a life in me yet. And let me tell you, the sound is gonna rise again. When you start in a ditch, you quickly learn to plow. So darling, 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 take a damn good look, look at me now. Hey there, Mr. Chaplin, you may think I'm rather small, 'cause the posh papers are falling at your feet. So go ahead and snub me, and don't return my call, and build your house on top of Easy Street. But what you're gonna do when it all falls down, 'cause I let a little rumor spread. What you're gonna do if I change the name of the person sleeping in your bed? What you're gonna do when I tell the tale that makes the country turn its head? Just a little gossip and just a little lie, I'll simply say the little tramp is just a little spy. And what you're gonna do when it all falls down? Hey there, Mr. Chaplin, well, your act deserves applause. You wave our flag and the country is impressed. What you're gonna do when the money's gone, and who you're gonna buy to care? What you're gonna do when the country says, now get yourself out of here? What you're gonna paint when you cannot paint the town? I'm gonna wipe the smile from that famous little clown. And what you're gonna do when it all,
well, I we can't thank you guys enough. The talent is incredible. Your passion, your dedication, the amount of work you put to coordinate this and bring this to us. Thank you for that. Thank you for sharing your love for theater, your love for singing, and your love for the arts with us. This was inspiring and beautiful and lovely, and we are so grateful to all of you for being a part of it. And we'll be back in 2 weeks with another edition of Full Moon Fridays. Until then, stay healthy, do the census, vote, wear your mask, get yourself a kick-ass table.
And have a wonderful weekend. Thank you for sharing the last 90 minutes with us. L'chaim, thank you all.
Thank you.